Osho, welcome back to my friend's YouTube channel. Osho, we are practicing le negative. Today we are going to practice negatives. So let's start with the first question. Mete o negative? I hope that you are having a notebook with you. So keep solving along with me. First part, pa o. So just see the case. This is which kind of sentence? It's an imperative sentence. So how are we going to make the negative? It's a pronoun here. So in negative, we bring the pronoun before the verb and it becomes no par pa. No par pa. Second part, yakil deza dona paniye. If I have given you in the form of question, you have to leave it as it is because the question is mete o negative. If it's reponde, then you are going to reply. If it's not reponde, you are just going to keep the sentence as it is. Yatil dezaf dola paniye. So in yatil, before y, we are going to write na, an apostrophe, because y is also a vowel. So nya til pa de. It's an article. Which article? Les article partitif. They will change to the daf dola paniye. Nyatilpa daf dola paniye. Are there no eggs in the basket? So it will remain same. Next one. Kelka abhyu dyume. So if expressions are used here, you also have to use the expression while answering it in negative. Kelka beautiful. Someone drank some wine. So kelka negative will be person. If the positive word is in the starting, the negative word will also be in the starting. So person, this is our verb. Na will be before the first verb. So person na bu. Du will change to the. Don't forget to change the articles. Very important. The when. Next one, tu ekre pula sware. Sware, so you need to see the word tu can be used for things and person both. Okay? Do you remember we use it for tulmond? So it can be used for both. It can be used for a thing, it can be used for a person. So when we are using it for a thing, then our answer will be in the negative, we are going to write ria. And if we are using it for the person, in the negative, it will be person. So right now, if you read the sentence and understand the meaning of the sentence, tu ekre pula sware. So it is, everyone is ready for the evening party. So we're talking about people. And negative will be, no one is ready for the party. So person ne pre, that's ready. Pula sware. Oma continue la question. Let's move on to some more parts. Ilzo deja shonte. Now we have to see again a positive word is given here. Ilzo deja shonte. So how are we going to make the negative? Il no. Pas encore chante. So, déjà negative is pas encore. Next one, vous avez tout compris. Now, again, the word tout is given. We just discussed in our earlier sentence. We need to see tout is used for a thing or for a person. So, vous avez tout compris. You have understood everything. So, you have not understood anything. So, it is vous n'avez, before the verb we write an apostrophe, and tu negative will be rien. Vous n'avez rien compris. You didn't understand anything. The next one, je vais toujours à l'école. Again, positive word is given. So, je ne vais. You can also do along with me. Je ne vais jamais. Jamais à l'école. The next sentence, j'ai vu quelqu'un. This is something which is important. You need to see this quelqu'un is given in which tense. This word is used with passé composé, past tense. So when it's used with past tense, can you observe this thing? With the first verb, we are writing ne plus verb plus negative, okay? So verb, you can see first verb, ne plus verb plus negative. But when it's quelqu'un, so quelqu'un negative will be personne. Now, you will be writing je n'ai vu personne. Personne will be with the past participle. It will be with the second verb. So, this happens in two cases. One is personne and one is nul par. So, do remember this. Personne and nul par will be after the past participle. And except these two, you are going to write all of them before the first verb. Next one. Il y a quelque chose dans la boîte. So, again positive word is given. Il n'y a quelque chose negative is? Rien, très bien. Il y a rien. There's nothing dans la boîte. In the box. Très bien. Next one. J'ai du pain et du beurre. I have some bread and some butter. So this is a. This is which case? This is neither nor case. So je n'ai. What happens in this? Now two different nouns are there with article partitive. So how are you going to do it? Je n'ai ni pain, neither bread. Just remove partitive article also. Ni pain, ni beurre, ni nor butter. So I have neither bread nor butter. I've also written one more question for you, which is répondre au négatif. Reply to the negative. Let's quickly start. So all of them you need to reply in no. Voulez-vous des croissants? So the answer will start with no. Vous will change to nous. Ne. Voulez. With nous we are going to write voulons. Change the conjugation. It's very important. Pas. Again we have les articles participes. So it's going to change to de. Don't forget to change the articles. It's very important. De croissant. Next one, est-ce tu sembles vrai? Again, we have the word tu. So, what do you think? What can be the answer? Sembler means to seem. And vrai, vrai ou faux? Do you remember what is vrai? Yes, absolutely true. So, dash, sembler seems to be true. So, everyone or everything? Everything is more appropriate here. So, everything seems to be true. And the negative will be no. Rien. Only two options you have with tu. Either it can be rien or it can be personne. So rien ne semble, nothing seems to be true. Last part. Tu vas quelquefois voir tes cousins. You're going sometimes to see your cousins. How are you going to make it? No. Tu will change to je. Je ne. Conjugation accordingly. Quelquefois will change to jamais, I never go to see. And again, adjective possessive will also change to mais. So you need to keep in mind the entire sentence. So I've given so many parts for your practice. Keep practicing and if you have any doubt, put it down in the comment section. I'll see you in the next video. Au revoir.